Yeah. Is someone excited today?
Yes.
If you are excited, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you are shouted, excited, you are next in line with this one.
Hallelujah.
If you are excited, your testimony will come now.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I like the excitement in here today.
Hallelujah.
We shall call our sister, Sister Felicia, to give us a testimony.
Hallelujah. Give me victory. The judge opened, flipped things. He said, and the Home Office lawyers came prepared, very prepared. They were just throwing up because already before the day, we had already, my solicitor had already sent what we needed, you know, to present on the day. So they found that we have nothing. So they came prepared. And then the day, the judge said, we actually have nothing here. Like, what is she actually going to talk about? There is nothing here. Then the Home Office lawyer said that makes her job easier for her. Then the judge said, myself and my barrister should go out and decide between the two of us what we want her to do. Because there is nothing, we didn't present anything. So we came out and my barrister said, oh, okay, we are going to ask for adjournment. And that's going to take like about another year because I waited a year to get my hearing. So he said, we are going to ask for adjournment because your solicitor did not prepare anything. The moment my barrister went out, I said, speaking in tongues, I said, the God of Word and Fire Ministry. I said, that rise for me, Lord. I don't want this case to be adjourned. I just want it to be sealed today, finally. I said, the God of Pastor Kenneth Njume, where are you? He so believed in his prophecy. So today I'm going to test that prophecy. I started declaring, saying, God, if you are really the God that supports Word of Fire Ministry, you are really the God of Pastor Njume, arise for me. But I was still shaking. You know, I went to the toilet and I called Pastor. I was crying. I said, Pastor, just say something now.
She's very honest. Yes. She was not just crying, she was screaming.
I was screaming. I ran there and said, Pastor, pray now. We have 20 minutes. We are going to go in now. He said, it is done. He said, as you are going, everything is changing for you. I believed. I said, Lord, as I am going in, everything is changing. We went inside, and then the judge asked, so what have you guys thought of? So my barrister said, adjourning. He said, the Home Office said, they are not adjourning it because they have 1 year to prepare their case. They did nothing. Because they know they have nothing else, they say, adjourn. It's not done in the court of law. Then the judge said, yeah, it's true. I'm not going to adjourn it. I'm just going to work with what I have. While I sat there, I said, Holy Ghost. You know, she was just firing the both of them questions, and I sat down there, I was just looking. To cut a long story short, I came out and my barrister told me, he said, your case is
homeless.
And when I called Pastor, I said, Pastor said it is done. Then before I went out, the woman said, give me 20 days, I'll get back to you. On the 19th day, my solicitor called me. He said, hello, Ayan. I said, hello. I said, talk now. Before I say I am shaking, just talk now. What do you want to tell me? He said, you have been granted. Pastor has been declaring since this year, especially last week Sunday, he said...
Okay, he said wait first. I prophesy on her, which day? Last day of it. I said a package is coming in your hands. Were you all here?
Yes.
And
yes,
what happened? Yes. That's the package I'm talking about. And secondly, wait, I'm still thinking what to say here.
Hey,
how far you are, you've been to all, she's been to every, she might be surprised when I'm saying that, things I don't know. She's been roaming around in other ministry before she landed at Word and Fire Ministry. Sometimes you must be where God wants you to be for you to receive what God has for you. Her case was hopeless. There was no hope. That's why she was crying. Because even the lawyer told her, there's no hope yet. They had no case. You see, God will do things so that we all know that he bodily.
Yes.
Who did that? Jesus. Oh,
yes.
He went ahead and began to. Man, talk what you want to say now.
You can see that. You can see that. The smile I used to have when you came to me. The smile today is different.
Up your hands and celebrate Jesus for that testimony. Thank Jesus for that testimony. Thank Jesus for that testimony. Thank Jesus for that testimony. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, we are praying. The truth is that people get it outside more than here. So everyone that is watching now on the stream, I want them to, as they are watching this movie, this service, I want them to stretch your hand on the camera on the stream as I pray. If you are here, you have an immigration issue. In fact, it will be coming every month, we shall be having it.
Hallelujah.
God says, it will never be seen anywhere before.
Amen.
Everyone watching this service today,
yes,
there is no distance in the realm of the spirit. I pray in the name of Jesus, wherever your immigration documents are being held,
yes,
let the same God that did it for her do it for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray in the name of Jesus, anyone going through any season of the wilderness, by fire, by thunder, whoever is sitting on your case, let them have no peace from now until they release it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Romans 8:28 says, all things work out for good for those who love God. Everyone watching me and all those in here, every problem of your life ends now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This season is a season of financial breakthroughs in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Career breakthroughs in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take your promotion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take your fruitfulness in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take your breakthroughs unlimited in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
It is done in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All those watching me on the screen and everyone in here, check your pockets, check your accounts. Begin to check everything that you have checked before. The God of this ministry is restoring all in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Clap those hands for Jesus. Clap those hands for Jesus. Father, we thank you. In the name of don't bother. Don't bother. Just say, well, as I go, tap into that testimony. Say, God, over to you. And it will be done in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's take one more because of time and then we'll go. Grandma, you want to come and give us your testimony? Are you just clapping for Jesus? Are you just clapping for Jesus?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You can stand this way, sir.
I just want to say thank you to the Lord for what he has done for me.
Amen.
For about the last 2 weeks. In fact, I've always been sick since like 2 months. And I was always praying, and it seems like it was not willing to answer my prayers. And I've been talking to that to the pastor, and we have been praying together. He has been giving me some advice on what to do, what I have to do, how I have to pray, all the things I have to do. And I kept on praying and mourning to the Lord. And finally, my health is ameliorating, and it's getting better. I mean, and
it is restored in the name of Jesus.
And I just want to say thank you to the Lord for all these things, and I pray, I know that it will perfect my healing, and it will
accomplish
all these things that you for me. Thank you.
He is healed completely in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He could not talk. The day will tell you, could not. No speech coming out. Remember the thing, our first Holy Ghost fire, and the Holy Ghost located him there. And I said that the according to the enemy, he was not meant to cross over. Yeah. But God in his mercy.
Amen.
He could not talk. At one point he could not walk. He's talking now. You might think it's that easy, but he was going through something. But God is good. I believe that all what he was going through was for God, the Holy Ghost, to walk through it.
Amen.
And I believe that the Holy Ghost has had his way, and restoration is complete in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are not going to be healed. Your health is not ameliorating. Everything is sound. He had so much pain in his throat, he could not even spit. But now it is restored in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's thank God for those testimonies.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Bless your heart. It is offering time now, please.